It's buzzing in here ahead of game three. And we'll be back in a minute to get it started. Welcome to St. Louis and Busch Stadium, home of the Cardinals since 2006. MLB The Show brings you the National League Championship Series. It's the Los Angeles Dodgers, the St. Louis Cardinals. John Ciambi, Chris Singleton with you. A lot going on in this series as we get ready for game three, Singy.
Well, when a team starts a series on the road and comes away with a split in the first two games, they've essentially taken over home field advantage. So the last thing these guys want to do now is give it right back by dropping this one. And these fans know that just as much as the players.
And the atmosphere here is electric. And this figures to be about as intense as postseason baseball gets. All right, we'll be back to get this one started after this. So just about set now. And on the hill in this one, Miles Michaelis. Chris, how about a scouting report?
A really good outing for him last time. Scattered two runs, was attacking hitters, getting ahead in the count. Great performance. We'll see if he can do it again in this one.
All right, ready to get underway. Mookie Betts will get us started. To third, Arenado collects. Over to first, and Betts is set down.
Batting second, the shortstop, Trey Turner.
Here's Turner now. Good contact guy, good defender. No score just getting started, top of the first. And a swing and a miss there.
This guy's got such a good sinker. As a hitter, you've got to look up in the zone. If you look down, you're going to be chasing stuff in the dirt.
Next pitch just misses. And now 3-2. One down, base is empty. That one drilled left field. That's back there. Up against the wall and makes the catch.
Tried to take on the wind in left field right there. Just a little too much traffic up in the air. Mother Nature won that one. It's hard to say, but I think that might be gone otherwise.
Justin Turner now. And a pitch. And another ball.
Well, he's so great about hitting the ball the other way. He gets those arms extended. So right there, just trying to straighten him up a little bit so he doesn't have as much outside plate coverage.
And the 2-2. And a foul ball. He stays alive. Here's the 2-2. And a base hit up the middle. And that keeps the inning going.
I could watch base hits like that one all day long, and so could every hitting coach in the league. Just a nice line drive into center field.
Two outs, runner at first. Freddie Freeman steps to the plate for the Dodgers. The 2-1. And a good eye there. Out to short, over to Edmund, and that is that. One left for LA. Now the Cardinals will see what they can do. There's no score. Major League Baseball is on the show. Bottom of the first. Clayton Kershaw getting the start. How about a report on him, Chris?
Yeah, Bogey got the win last time out, worked deep into the ball game and scattered a couple of hits. You can expect him today to try to match that performance of his last time out.
We go to the bottom of the first, and stepping in is the speedy Tommy Edman. Strike two.
Count is one and two.
Bounce to the left side. Throw on to Freeman. One up, one down.
Batting second, the first baseman, Paul Goldschmidt.
Here's Paul Goldschmidt. Singing, you can't ask for anything more. This guy checks all the boxes offensively.
He is the ultimate professional, and it doesn't just start at game time. It starts in the afternoon, the way he prepares and gets ready for the ball game. I tell you what, his teammates feed off of the leadership that he shows on and off the field.
Stays alive. Kershaw fires. Pitch in the dirt, and it's two and two. And here it comes. That one missed. And he walked him.
Oh, looking for a swing and miss right there, or for the ump to help him out and make a call with that last pitch, but neither happened. Close pitch, but a good take to earn that walk.
One down. And here is Tyler O'Neill. This guy has turned into a beast. Next offering is in for a strike. Goldie leads off first with one away. Ground ball could be two. There's one, and it's a double play to end the inning. First frame of the night behind us, and it's nothing nothing. Top of the second, and up to the plate is Will Smith. And the righty deals. And that one is lifted in the air. Bader raging back towards the wall. Can't get there, and now maybe extra bases. And that's a leadoff double.
Well, he found himself behind in the count right there, but he didn't give in. That was exactly what you're looking to do with the pitch away, especially in that situation. Drive it into the opposite field gap. Got himself two bags on a great swing of the bat. Runner in scoring position now, and a good opportunity to push across the first run of the ballgame.
Max Muncy steps to the plate for the Dodgers. Big time power. 1-1 now. Comes up empty. That's strike two. No score here in the second. Next offering is fouled back. Next pitch misses way outside. Foul ball, he stays alive. Left-hand batter waits, and it's filled up. And he deals. Chopped left side. Arenado picks it up, tosses across to first. They go 5-3 for the first out as the third baseman makes the play from the shortstop spot in the shift. Chris Taylor now.
Hitter's got some good opposite field power. What I like about something being hit to the right side into the outfield is that the base runner at second has a very good read and can determine whether or not he can score on that base hit.
Two and one now. That one drifts inside. Ed Drummond behind the plate calling balls and strikes. Maybe one of the most respected umpires around the league.
He's not the kind of umpire that you're likely to notice back there. And that can be a huge compliment, really. So if you're just kind of quietly doing your job, staying consistent with your calls, hitters, pitchers, managers.
And there's a fly ball deep right field. Drops in for a hit. Couldn't run it down. Smith around third. He will score and the Dodgers have the lead. 1-0.
Well done. Drives in the run. That was one of those swings that feels like you're swinging an aluminum bat. It jumped off so hard, squared it up, and it went screaming at 108 miles per hour.
And now it's Gavin Lux. The 2-1. That clips the corner. One out and a runner at second. On the ground, right side. Gets it to first. Got the out. Bellinger up to hit.
And this is a big opportunity for him to pick up his teammate right here.
Next offering upstairs. Two outs with a runner at third. And that one fouled off. Two and two stays alive. Two, two down. The other way, and that one gets down. Fair ball. In to score is the runner from third. It's 2-0. To second, but way too late. Safe there.
Picks himself up an RBI. Anytime you rip a line drive the other way, you feel really good about what you did at the plate. You trusted your hands, you let the ball travel, and you took the barrel straight to it. That's great work right there.
Here's Mookie now. Next offering is fouled back. Bellinger on its second with two down. The 3-2 is off the outside edge, and that is ball four. So first and second with two outs. Here's a speed threat, Trey Turner. The 1-1. And that one pulled foul. Now this is in the air down the line. Grabs it on the run. And the inning is over. We go to the bottom of inning number two. It's the Dodgers 2 and the Cardinals nothing. Back here at Busch Stadium. And now the veteran third baseman, Nolan Arenado.
Well, after putting up a nice inning on offense, got some runs across, this is where you look for the starter to go out there, have a shutdown inning. Don't give that other team any hope. You just hope that he can get through this inning, get the bats back up there while they're hot.
Swing and a miss. Now 1-2. And that one ripped into right, and there's a base hit. Off to a good start with a leadoff dot.
Well, that'll make you feel good as a hitter right there. When you can turn a ball around at 107 off the bat, it's going to make you feel really good inside.
If he elevates that a little bit more, it's definitely out of here.
And you can feel this crowd waking up a bit here as the guys are starting to make some noise with their bats.
This is Dylan Carlson. Next pitch is outside, and it's 2-1. That one catches the corner for a strike. Got him swinging on the curveball. One away. Here's Albert Pujols. The 1-1. And it's fouled away. And now the lefty. And now it's even up.
I got to count 2-2.
Tying run at the plate. That one is absolutely belted. This one's got a chance. Hauls it in on the warning track.
And he hammered that to straightaway center field. It's a deep part of the ballpark. Tell you what, that wind is blowing straight in. Got to be a big man if you're going to go through the wind of that part of the park. It just knocked that ball down.
Next pitch in the dirt. Two balls, two strikes to count with two outs. Betts is on the move. And there's a ball.
3-2, two out, runner on first. A lot of movement in the infield. Hitter's got to stay focused on the pitch.
Kicks and deals. That one the other way. Has some trouble with it. The flip to the pitcher covering. And Molina is retired. And that will end the inning. So one left for the Cardinals. And they're down 2-0. Here in St. Louis, Turner climbs in on that right side. Fly ball down the line, and Turner is retired. One up, one down. Freddie Freeman steps to the plate for the Dodgers. He's 0-1. Right-hander kicks, deals.
The count is 2-1.
Awkward swing there from the big left-handed hitter.
Off balance as well.
And down on strikes he goes. Now two away.
Well, big power guy right there and generating so much bat speed. It's hard to bring that to a halt once you've committed. They tried to check the swing, just couldn't do it.
Next one just misses. 2-2. Righty delivers. High fly ball out into left center field. Bader in position. Brings it in for the third out. Dodgers go down quietly as they're unable to add to their 2-0 lead. And welcome back. Bottom of the inning. Now here is Paul DeJong. The 1-1. Popped up to the left. Into foul ground. Turner has a beat on it. And a quick out number one.
Batting ninth, the center fielder, Harrison Bader.
And now Bader up to the plate. And a pitch. Line drive, base hit.
Pitch was in and off the plate. So hard to do anything with a pitch in that location, but somehow he got the barrel to it and hit it well. Pretty amazing. And now they've got some speed on first, so we'll see if they try to get him into motion.
Tommy Edman at the plate. Bader runs. That's in for a strike. Safe at second, and he easily steals the bag.
Well, in the postseason, I'd say we see more teams playing for one run, trying to apply some pressure, and that's exactly the case right here. Speed on the bases, put him in motion, and it worked out. Now time to execute in the batter's box.
And a pitch. And now it's filled up. Here comes a pitch. In the air, out towards left center. Can't get there, base hit. Here comes Bader around third. He'll score easily, and they trail by one. He's safe at third, and the tying run is 90 feet away.
Couple of hits in a row for him here. Just a beautiful triple from start to finish. Got a pitch he could drive, turned on it, and hammered it out front into the gap. Right out of the box. I love how he was hustling, and I think he knew he was going for three as soon as it touched down.
Now it's Goldschmidt up to the plate. That one to first. There for the out. Runner scores from third. Tyler O'Neill next up for the Cardinals. He hit into a double play his first time up. Kershaw to 2-1. Pulls that one foul.
He's gone off speed. He needs to elevate here with two strikes out of the zone.
The wind of the pitch. And a foul ball. He stays alive. The big lefty turns, kicks, deals. Good eye right there. Three, two. Swing and a ball lifted left field. Taylor settles under this one. He's got it. And that ends the inning. Game three moves on to the fourth. We are tied 2-2. Welcome back. John Ciambi with Chris Singleton, and set to lead off the fourth, Max Muncy. And a 2-1 on the way. Swing and a high fly ball down the left field line, but hooking foul. Now that's smack to right center. And there's one down.
It was all over that fastball right there. I tell you what, if he gets under it just by a fraction of an inch or a little bit more, that's way back.
And next for LA, Chris Taylor. One for one with a double and a run scored. Here's a 1-1. Up the middle, knocks it down. No throw, and the speedy runner is on at first.
Wasting no time. He's 2 for 2 now on the night, and just a triple and home run away from the cycle.
Seriously, we're starting with this already. So up next, Gavin Lux. The pitch. Lux checks his swing, appeal to third. That's a swing, according to umpire Woody Keller. Next offering misses. It's 2-2.
This is one of those situations defensively where you can't try to do too much. You got to make sure that you field the ball cleanly and get one out first. It's going to be tough to get two with this kind of speed in the batter's box.
Stays alive.
With two strikes, may see some movement over there at first base, trying to stay out of a double play here.
Michaelis keeping an eye on him. Left-hand hitter waits. And now it's filled up.
So here we go. Base runner at first. Could be running on the pitch. He's got good enough speed to steal the bag to get in scoring position, even if it's a swing and miss at the plate.
3-2. Swing and a pop-up. Foul territory for the catcher. Molina pulls it down. That's out number two.
No, that was a pitch you got to crush. Unbelievable that he missed it right there. And I'm telling you, he is going to be frustrated with himself until his next at bat.
And up to the plate comes Cody Bellinger. Taylor, the runner at first with two gone. Next offering is in for a strike. And a pitch. And a foul ball. He stays alive. This one in the air, center field. Bader gets under it. And that is that. So the Dodgers leave one. Score remains 2-2. Bottom four. Now up the Cardinals' number four hitter, Nolan Arenado. The wind of the pitch. And now the count is even. The wind of the pitch. Stays alive. The pitch. Slice to right. That's a base hit. So a man on base to start the inning.
Gotta love the resiliency he showed in that at bat, battling with two strikes. I don't know how he's able to shoot that pitch the other way and still put something on it. That pitch was inside, and he let it get really deep, so pretty incredible hands to fight it off and still get good wood on it.
Dylan Carlson next up for the Cardinals. The pitch. And a count 1-2. Runner at first with no outs here.
Clearly trying to stay back a little bit longer for that changeup as he fouls that fastball back.
Line drive. Nice grab.
That ball was ticketed for right center field all the way, but not so fast, the second baseman says. Leaps up into the air and brings it down. Some nice hang time as well when he was up there.
And now it's Albert Pujols' turn to hit. That one hammered left field. That's back there. And that one is gone. Albert Pujols goes deep. And the Cardinals have the lead now. It's 4-2.
Slider on the outside part of the plate is typically hit the other way, but to be able to get to it, pull the baseball, and get it up in the air for a home run, I'm just really impressed.
And stepping up to the dish is Yadier Molina. The pitch. And that one off the outside edge. Still only one out here in the inning. This one popped up. Foul ground first base side. Smith puts it away. Two down.
Now batting. Shortstop. Paul DeJong.
Two outs. Base is empty. Now it's Paul DeJong up to the plate. He popped out his first time. Two outs. Popped up. Lux makes the catch, and that'll do it. Two runs for St. Louis on this blast. It's now 4-2. Back here at the ballpark, we go to the top of the fifth. Here's Mookie Betts. The 3-1. And a strike. Bullpen activity starting up now. Brandon Waddell up and loosening in the pen. Woodford getting cranked up as well. Righty to the plate. That's hard hit in the line. Dives. What a play. So a great diving catch, and that was only possible because of the route he took to get there, right, Chris?
Yeah, StatCast shows us just how efficient that route to the ball was. In fact, that's about as good as it gets, pretty much a direct line to it. And perhaps he was a wide receiver in a different life, I don't know, but man, great job to hold on all the way through the dive as well. No fumble caused by the ground.
Makes the grab, and there's two gone. Two outs, base is empty. And at the plate for the Dodgers, Justin Turner, 1-for-2. The wide to kick the pitch. Fly ball to right. Carlson moving under it. He makes the grab, and that's the inning. Nothing doing for the Dodgers here. They trail it here, 4-2. back here at Busch Stadium. We head to the bottom of the fifth. Now, Harrison Bader.
It's good speed at the top of the order here. You want to get it on, see if you can get a stolen base, maybe get around the bases and pick up a run.
And here it comes. Out to short, Turner picks it up, and the leadoff man set down in their half of the fifth.
Well, a well-thrown slider like that one can be tough to get in the air. Good downward break on that one.
So the lineup flips over, and now Tommy Edman, a switch hitter batting right. Next offering is down low. Out towards right center field. Bellinger makes the catch. Two away now.
This is important. If he can go 1-2-3 here, will be a very positive sign for him and for his team.
Paul Goldschmidt next up for the Cardinals. And a pitch. And that's a base hit. And that keeps the inning alive.
All over that one right there. That's a good sound coming off the bat, man. And as he connected out front and lifted into the outfield, that's one of those swings where you just don't even feel the ball hit the barrel. That's a pure stroke.
So two down. Here's Tyler O'Neill. Next pitch is outside. Goldie leads off first with two down to the inning. In the air, fairly deep to right field. Makes the grab, and that's the inning. The Cards leave one, but they still lead this one 4-2. New arm on the mound for the Cardinals, Brandon Waddell. And he'll do his best to hang on to this lead.
Well, at this point of the ball game, we're talking about middle innings and a little length out of this arm coming out of the bullpen. We'll see just how many outs he's able to give his skipper.
And welcome back. And here's the first baseman, Freddie Freeman. Left-hand batter waits. That misses off the outside edge.
Talk about the right guy at the right spot. They really need a rally, and this guy is someone you can believe in to find a way to get on base.
Next offering is down low. Now 3-1. And that's in for a strike.
No need to offer that pitch until you get to two strikes. It's just a low percentage of success when you want to try to go after that down and away pitch.
Sharp grounder. That's through for a base hit.
Just kept it simple, played pepper with the middle of the infield and took it back where it came from, and there's just no one there to knock it down.
The batter now will be Will Smith. And now the lefty. And that's outside.
Now these guys definitely looking for a big swing of the bat right here. Try to close that gap. But, you know, at the very least, if you could find a way to manufacture that run from first, it feels like it's really important to getting back into this ballgame.
And he deals.
Well, that's off the plate.
fouls one away, and now 3-2. At the belt and fires. Now fly ball to right center. Can't get there. Base hit. And now runners at the corners. Nobody out.
Two consecutive base hits for these guys here. Just a cookie down the middle. I mean, those are the ones you dream about. The ones in the cage, you're just hoping you get in the ball game. Right down the middle, not a whole lot of velocity, right on top of it.
Here comes Max Muncy. Lefty out of the stretch, runners at first and third.
Could be some action here on this next pitch. Couple runners on, probably a challenge pitch coming.
And now this one's a rocket to right. Way back there. Gone. Max Muncy leaves the yard. His second homer of this series. And they jump out front. It's 5-4. Well, that swing changes things.
Yes, it does. They were in striking distance. They found a way to fight back big time. Knew what pitch he wanted to hit, spit on some other pitches in this at bat, was very patient, and it paid off.
A new arm into the game, the righty, Nick Wittgren. He's into the game with the bases empty.
They know that he can get a right-hander out, but he's in position to face a couple of lefties this inning.
Chris Taylor digs in now.
And a 1-2.
And a ball evens the count. And the right-hander deals. Swing and a miss and a changeup in the dirt. Molina to first. Gets him. One away on a drop third strike. The batter has a second base. Gavin Lux. Gavin Lux steps to the plate for the Dodgers. Line to left. Pulls it down, and he makes the catch. And there are two down.
Man, that's one of those at-bats where you have to remind yourself it's about the process. He did everything right there. Nothing to show for it. But in your mind, you have to convince yourself that it was a very good at-bat.
Swing and a miss. One and two. Double-barreled action in the bullpen. Cody Whitley getting ready to go. Hicks warming up as well. And he chases that one. And that will end the inning. Big three-run shot for the Dodgers. It's now a 5-4 ball game. Back here in St. Louis, where we go bottom six. Here's Nolan Arenado. The pitch. So a foul ball makes it 1-2. One out.
No, you know that. that's got to be very frustrating for this guy. He knows the strike zone extremely well. And you know what? Good hitters are not going to compromise. He'll take that punch out, but ultimately stick with his plan and have more success than anything else.
And now the right fielder, Dylan Carlson. Next pitch misses, and it's 3-2. Kicks and fires. Fouled off again, and it remains 3-2. The wind of the pitch. The 3-2 is off the outside edge, and that is ball four.
What a battle. It's not always easy laying off a 3-2 pitch, and I tell you what, he earned that walk.
Next is the designated hitter, Albert Pujols. So right-handed slugger at the plate. Chrissy is surprised that the lefty is still in there.
Extremely. I mean, you've got arms down in the bullpen, and there's somebody down there that can match up, try to get out of this jam.
Three-two on the way. And a foul ball. He stays alive. Kershaw checks on the runner, and he's back in there. Carlson stands at first with one out. That one the other way. Hauls it in for the out.
Now batting, catcher, Molina.
Now Molina at the plate. And a pitch. 3-2 now. Pitch. Swing and a miss, and that is that. So one left for the Cardinals. Still down a run. It's 5-4. The new pitcher in the game, Jordan Hicks. And he'll do his best to keep this close.
Jordan.
All set for the start of the inning. And the batter now, Mookie Betts.
Well, he's always a threat. Even if this guy is 0-for-3 for the night with three strikeouts, he can come up that fourth time and do damage because he's that good.
Swing and a high fly ball out there towards left field. Fielding for the wall, makes the catch in foul ground.
Well, off the bat, I thought for sure it had enough to get out of here, but that wind's kind of blowing in from left, and I think that's what made the difference.
Here's Trey Turner. Right-hander kicks, deals.
Ball match outside.
Swing and a slow roller. Over to Goldie. And they get Turner for the out.
Good sinker low in the zone right there and produced exactly what he was looking for. Ball on the ground. Nice ground out.
So now Turner in on that right side. Next pitch is downstairs. And the righty deals. Stays alive. Next offering is downstairs.
this point in the game, you cannot issue free passes. He's going to have to challenge this hitter. Hitter's got to be ready to swing it.
Fouled off again, and it remains 3-2. Two down, nobody on. Lined, and that's a base hit.
Just one of those at-bats you almost hate to see come to an end. Nice job of driving that pitch the other way on a line. You know, hitters, they take so many reps in the cages working on going to the opposite field, and it doesn't always translate into the game, but right there it did, and he did it perfectly.
Here comes Freddie Freeman up to hit. So now 1-2. Way high. Two, two down. Ripped to third and picked on a hop. Over to Edmund, and that'll do it. One left for LA as they hold on to a 5-4 lead. New pitcher on here, Phil Bickford. Trying to protect this lead.
Number 52, Phil Bickford.
Ready to go for the last half of the inning. Now it's the shortstop, Paul DeJong. The tying run at the plate. Just missed. Activity in the bullpen. Lake trying it. The veteran right-hander appears to be loosening up. Hudson getting loose as well. In for a strike. Now it's 3-2.
Well, it looks like he's wanting to work the upper part of the strike zone. What does that mean? Top hand better be working for the hitters. Adjust that side a little bit. Give yourself a chance to hit.
Popped up. Turner on the move. Holds it in on the run. And there's one down.
Now batting, center fielder, Harrison Bader.
Here's the center fielder, Harrison Bader.
Trying to keep good speed off the bases.
The next offering misses. 2-1. Bounce to the right. Throw pulls him off the bag, and he's safe.
Well, I definitely think the speed down the line played a factor on that throw. He had more time than he thought, but as a fielder, the speed of the game and the speed of the runner sometimes can get in your head, and he just rushed it and failed to make a clean throw.
Back to the top of the lineup. Now up for St. Louis, Tommy Edmund for the fourth time tonight. Kicks and deals. Here's the pitch. Runner on the go. There's a ball, and that's a stolen base, not even close.
Well, it seems like 90 feet is such a big deal in a tight one-run game like this one. Maybe it's a little bit risky, but they felt good about it, and it paid off. Let's see if they can turn this into a big run.
Back to work, 3-2 now. And a foul ball, he stays alive. Righty delivers, stays alive. Runner leads away at second. Betts is on the move. Great catch, foul ground up against the wall.
Well, I think the wind ended up being a factor right there. It's whipping in from right field right now. So otherwise, I think that ball's out of here.
New pitcher on now, Brusdar Graterol. He'll try to strand the runner at second. At the plate, Paul Goldschmidt.
Yeah, Boog, if you're that base runner at second base, you want to be quiet out there. Not bouncing around, not distracting your teammate, the hitter. Make sure that he can clearly focus on that pitcher and that release point.
The pitch. Up the middle. Lux throws the first in time. Inning over. The Cards leave one. They trail it 5-4. Cody Whitley into the game, and his job is to collect quick outs and keep his team within striking distance. Welcome back. We go to the eighth, and at the plate for the Dodgers, Will Smith. Here's a 1-1. Popped up first base side. Goldie makes the catch, and there's one away.
Now batter, designated hitter, Max Muncy.
And a pitch. Muncy, the next to hit, takes outside. Movement in the bullpen. Ryan Helsley getting loose out there. Right-handed reliever. And a swing and a miss.
And he really sells the changeup with that arm action.
Left-hand hitter waits. Swing and a miss. The velocity blasted it right past him.
Thought it was a pretty good pitch. Top of the strike zone. We're seeing more fastballs in that location. Hitters, especially with two strikes, have to be ready to pull the trigger.
Here's the left fielder, Chris Taylor. Right side, hard hit. Fires over to first. And that is that. Dodgers down in order. They lead it 5-4. Ready for the bottom of the eighth. And stepping in for the Cardinals, Tyler O'Neill.
Now, this guy, a player that, if he gets on base, has the ability to really be aggressive getting around the base paths.
Next one misses, and now 3-1.
When we get to this part of the order, yeah, there's some pop there, but more likely there's some base hits. So very important to be patient. Let the pitcher walk you, if he will.
Here comes a pitch. Lifted in the air, right center field. Betts puts the squeeze on that one. One away.
Now batting, the third baseman, Nolan Arenado.
Here's Nolan Arenado.
If you don't get ahead in the count, you can forget about having any success against him.
Next offering misses, and it's 2-1.
Really been able to slow down the game tonight with his at-bats, and the biggest one he's had so far. He doesn't look anxious at all.
Swing and a drive. This one way back there. Going. That one is gone. We are tied. Nolan Arenado blasts one out. That's his third home run of the series, and we're starting over.
Just an excellent swing all the way around, and it had that sound coming off the bat that gets everyone's attention. Got a pitch to drive, short to the baseball, squared it up, and the backspin carried it out of here.
Digging in is the switch inning outfielder, Dylan Carlson. The pitch. And that's just foul. Back and forth we go, a seesaw battle in the late stages of this one. Next pitch misses. Two balls, two strikes. And here it comes. That's off the mark. And now it's 3-2. Tapped out in front of the plate. Throw on to Freeman, and he's out. Here's the Cardinal DH, Albert Pujols. He's already homered in this game. Three-one now. Good plate appearance there. Able to take the walk.
Well, he tried to nibble right there and just missed his spot. Hitter didn't offer at it. Now he has somebody to worry about over at first.
Two outs, runner on first. Now here is Yadier Molina. And he deals.
Yeah, I'm surprised we didn't see a visit from the pitching coach here. Just to remind him, focus on the hitter. Don't worry about anything else.
Two gone. The possible go-ahead run at first. Next pitch downstairs. 3-1. At the belt and fires. He swings and hits a fly ball. Center field. Bellinger trying to get to it. He's got it, and that is out number three. One for the Cardinals on the solo home run. All even at five apiece. Back here at Busch Stadium. New inning getting started. And now, Gavin Lux.
You know, this guy's great speed is in the back of that pitcher's mind. If he can get on, it's going to give him one more thing he's got to think about.
The next offering misses. 2-1. The pitch. Now a high fly ball out to left center. O'Neill settles underneath it, makes the catch, one up, one down. One down, here comes Cody Bellinger. And a pitch.
Nope, at the ball.
The other way, and he beats the shift.
Well, a big swing of the bat right there. Pretty good changeup on the outside corner, but he did exactly what you're supposed to do with that pitch. See it deep and keep your hands inside it to drive it the other way. Now a huge at bat in this game coming up.
Back to the top of the Dodgers order. Here's Mookie to hit. Not your prototypical leadoff guy. Gets on base, yes, but also some power. Next offering is in for a strike.
If you're a base runner, you got to stay dialed in here. Look for anything in the dirt. Try your best to get into scoring position.
Whitley checks the runner. Bellinger dives back. Foul ball there. K kicks and fires. Swing and a miss, struck him out, and there's two away.
Got him out on the front foot, couldn't keep the hands back long enough, and played right into the hands of the pitcher.
Trey Turner now at the plate. He's turned into one of the best shortstops in the game. And that one is lifted in the air. He can't get there. It's a base hit. Bellinger on his way home. And he's safe at the plate as they take the lead. 6-5.
Clutch hitting right there to give him the lead this late in the ball game.
I love the approach he had right there with that pitch. Not trying to do too much, but still looking to drive it. And that's exactly what he's able to do into the opposite field gap for the double.
They hand the ball over to a new arm, Ryan Helsley. A runner on second to deal with. He'll do his best to keep him there. Man in scoring position with two away. Here's Justin Turner. Slice to right. That's a hit. Flying around third is Turner. He will score. It's 7-5.
Got the job done to put him up by two. I'll tell you, man, it's such a good feeling when you smoke a line drive into the gap like that. I mean, sure, home runs are king, but I feel like nothing makes you feel like a true professional hitter more than a bolt the other way.
Runner at first with two away. Freddie Freeman up to the dish. And a 1-1. And another ball.
No, he's really working him away this at bat. Sometimes take a little bit off velocity. Try to get a rollover, something on the ground. Stay away from that big hole on the right side of the infield.
And a pitch. And a foul ball. He stays alive. And the right-hander deals. In the air, left field. O'Neill makes the catch, and that'll do it. 8-9-1 due up in the bottom of inning number 9. It's the Dodgers 7 and the Redbirds 5. So they turn to Craig Kimbrel, and he'll work on holding this lead. And welcome back. Bottom of the ninth, and the batter will be the shortstop, Paul DeJong. The pitch. And a count 1-2. Kimbrel, he's known as a reliever that excels in really tough situations, those high leverage spots. It seems like he's at his best in these situations, and obviously the ability to get the strikeout factors in. Swings and misses, and one gone.
Well, the first batter, it's always a big one for the closer. I mean, you get that punch out, you get settled in, you feel like you're in command out there on the mound from the jump, and kind of prevents any doubt from creeping into your mind or the guys that are playing behind you that, you know, you're going to wrap this thing up.
And the righty deals. And downstairs.
Yeah, there are certain guys that expect to come in and dominate, and they see the challenge, the battle, just a little bit differently. They trust their stuff, and they believe that their stuff is better than that guy standing in the batter's box, what his swing, what his ability is.
And a pitch. Just misses with that one. The mental approach is a big factor too, isn't it?
Yeah, Boog, it is. And, you know, for each guy, it can be a little different. Some people consciously work on focusing, slowing things down, breathing techniques. And then there's some players that are just natural, and they just seem to be more composed and less excitable.
Swing and a miss. Struck him out. Two gone now.
Now, it's kind of tough right here. Closer comes in, and he strikes out the first two hitters. It's hard not to feel defeated and that this is going to go quickly. But you got to go up there, maybe try to find a way to choke up on the bat, spread out, put the ball in play, and maybe you can extend this inning.
Back to the leadoff spot in the St. Louis lineup. And up next for St. Louis, Tommy Edman. In the air, center field. He'll squeeze it for the final out, and the Dodgers take home field advantage right back. They win game three to go up 2-1.
Game threes are very critical when you have a series tied at 1-1 because you put yourself up. Anytime you go down, you're always chasing. When you're up in the series, you feel like you're in the driver's seat. Nice win today.
Here's one final look at the line score from this one, Chris.
It was a close two-run game, and a couple of key moments just really made the difference. Not much separates these two teams.
A 7-5 final score in this one. For Chris Singleton and our entire crew, I'm John Ciampi saying so long.